All right, everybody, I'm in here now, and if you look down on the board here, when I got it all cleaned up, I'm getting no power, and one of the things I see now down here, and let me get this thing turned off here, one of the things I'm seeing now is I've got a lot of darkness down on the board. Down in here, it looks like this, maybe one of these metal oxide resistors went bad in a, maybe a little bit of a power surge came through, and these big orange looking, they're called metal oxide resistors, they take a lot of abuse. You know, something's got to reduce the power on this surge coming into this 120 volts coming into the unit. And one of the things that helps to knock that power down, that voltage down to a usable level, is these big resistors that resist the flow of power. And sometimes when you get a lightning strike or you get a power surge, these things can go bad because they're not designed to take, you know, thousands and thousands of volts through them. They're designed to take 120 up to 250 volts. But beyond that, if you get some power spike or something like that, they can go bad. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to flip this unit up on its side carefully here because this thing weighs a ton. And I'm going to take this, I'm going to find out where it's connected to at the bottom of the board here. And it's not as difficult as you think it is. And I'll remove one of the legs of that resistors to get it, the resistor, that metal oxide resistor, to get it out of the, off of the board so it's not affected by the other components that it's connected to. I will actually be able to test that in isolation to see if it has a break. So I'll go ahead now and I'll trace it on this side of the board. I have a solder remover here. I'll remove the solder, lift up a leg, and we'll test it. We'll put it on the meter here to see if we get any kind of reading at all. Hopefully we should get some voltage through there. If we get a zero reading, it means that we've got a bad resistor and we're going to have to replace that, but they're very common. I have a ton of them in my parts supply box down here. So this is a little more than usual, our replacing fuses and stuff, so let's keep our fingers crossed. So what we're doing now, we've actually identified the component in conjunction with my hot soldering iron. I'm using the bulb desoldering, and I pulled the solder off of that particular leg of that big metal oxide resistor. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to flip it back over again. I'm going to pull up the leg on that metal oxide resistor a little bit. I got my meter all set up here. And if I get a reading of zero, it'll show that that metal oxide resistor's gone bad. I can simply pop another one in, put the power to it slowly. I'll get the, get the variac out to take it real easy to slowly bring the power to the unit. The variac, I can control the voltage going to the unit so I don't, you know, just plug in, clip on the on button, and maybe I'll get everything smoke up, boom, and that'll be the end of the unit. I love this unit. I want to really be careful with it and bring up the voltage slowly and see if we get any activity on it, okay? I'm going to flip it over now. I'll do the test. As I have both ends of the positive and negative probes set up on that metal oxide resistor there to test it. And when I come over here and I look at the meter reading, what do I see? I get a reading of zero, which tells me that this metal oxide resistor is not carrying any electricity whatsoever through the middle of it. It should be carrying something through there. And sadly, that means that that metal oxide resistor has gone bad. So the next thing we want to do now is totally remove the other leg of that and then put a new one down. I got plenty of them, so we'll get cracking on that, and then we'll see what kind of result we get there. Voila, as simple as that. We got the new resistor set inside. Be very careful when you're using a hot soldering iron. Make sure kids aren't around. And as soon as you're done using it, make sure that you unplug it. And remember, get that joint, get that connection hot first before you add the solder. And make sure you use silver solder
and not plumber solder, because that just won't do the job for you. It'll do a really lousy job. And make sure you don't get any cold solder joints. Do a good job on it. So I'm now going to go ahead and I'm going to unplug the soldering iron, sit it safely on the side so that it can cool down. And now I'm going to carefully put the unit back. I'm going to get the variac, which is the variable power, put power to that slowly, and we'll see what we get. Okay, keep your fingers crossed, close and excited. Okay, guys, I've got good news and bad news on the Yamaha CR620. Okay, give us the bad news first. I can't find my darn variac. You know, that big light blue thing that I used that has the dial on top, that I can dial up the power from 0 to 120 volts and put it through the system. So the good news is, I figured I just took a shot. Okay, I think I knew what the problem was, and I think I fixed it. So I went ahead and pushed the power button. And now you can see that, well, maybe you can't on here, but down here, maybe you'll be able to see. We've got a red light indicator on there, meaning we now have power to the unit. And when I fiddle with the tuning knob here, you can see that the meter jumps up and down there as it's getting various strength signals. So I think we've now got power to the unit. I think it really was that bad metal oxide resistor on there. So what we want to do now is, I apologize for not using the variac. You know, it was unsafe. This thing could have blown up, but I want to stop a second and give you, to discuss this protective relay again, and to show you how that works, and how that also helps to protect the unit in case something goes bad in the power supply. Okay, so give me a second. We'll flip the unit off and I'll give you a good demonstration of that. Okay, if you look where I'm pointing now, this is called the protective relay, the unit's protective relay. And as I mentioned, when you first put power on the unit, it's going to run around the circuit. It's going to do a little simple test here. It's going to use a little chip to sort of test to make sure that there's no short circuits anywhere that could blow out the tuning circuit over here, which is very critical, and also the amplifier circuit right in here. So when you first click on the power, you'll be able to hear. You may not be able to see. I'll get as close as I can in here. You may not be able to see, but you'll certainly hear when I click the power on. There'll be about a 2-second delay, and then you'll hear that relay click in, allowing power to go through the unit, which is showing that it's okay now. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Okay, did you hear that click off? I'll turn it off again. You can actually see the relay move, and it's frustrating to a lot of people that repair their own stereos, because it's hard to keep that relay from going off and putting power through the rest of the unit. So it makes it difficult to diagnose repair jobs sometimes, but most times when this relay doesn't trip and doesn't allow power to go through the unit, it's because something's wrong with the power board over here. It could be the transformer's gone bad, it could be some of the capacitors have gone bad here, it could be a bad transistor. But in our case here, it was a bad metal oxide resistor down here that I was able to replace with an equivalent unit. So once again, I'll show you, we'll get it in as close as we can here. We'll allow that to see if that's gonna focus a bit. Back that off just a tad. And then you may or may not be able to hear that there. We got a good focus now. I'll just click it on. Did you see that relay jump? And that's called the circuit protective relay. Okay, just learn a little something about how stereo amplifiers protect themselves. So let's go ahead now and hook up some speakers and an antenna and see what we get. Okay, I'm not gonna pretend that this is the first time I flipped the power on. I got two speakers set up here, two nice JVC speakers. Okay, it works, you know. Let's click it on now, and it sounds wonderful, as a Yamaha should. relay just kicked in, and now we just tuned down. We got a hell of a nice Yamaha unit now. It needs to be relamped. If you can see the red light down here. We don't have any antenna on this. Gotta really be careful. This thing will blow you out. Treble. Get the new lights and everything for it. So thank you so much for watching.